If you're looking for some quality summer football, look no further than Little Rock on Father's Day weekend.
It's day two of Shootout of the South as the premier 7-on-7 event in Arkansas comes to a close with the championship tournament. And the only thing hotter than the weather today was the competition right here at PA.
32 teams will dwindle down to a consolation bracket winner, a runner-up, and a single event champion. Out-of-state teams look to shock some Arkansans, while those from the natural state look to protect their home turf. Bryant won it all the last time this event was ran. After getting knocked off by Marion today, the three-time defending state champs faced Trinity Christian of Texas in the consolation bracket quarterfinals, and it ended with a stunner. Tied up and in overtime, an interception earns 2 points for the Hornets to allow them to move on. Bryant would go on to beat Valonia in the semis and eventually take down another Lone Star State team in Sherman to take the consolation title. Staying in quarterfinals and going to the winner's bracket, one of the plays of the day today came from Arkansas's own Warren High. The Lumberjacks need to score to tie. Time expiring, receiver Jared Payne makes the grab over a Patriot, and he follows that right up with a 2-point conversion to send Warren to the semis. Meanwhile, Conway put up a good fight, but fell to Keller of Texas, as goes for Greenbrier as they came up short to Madison Richland Academy of Mississippi. On to the winner's bracket semis, the hosting school and longtime 7-on-7 power Pulaski Academy going head-to-head with Keller. PA finds themselves in trouble early, and the Indians get off to a fast start. The Bruins eventually lose this one as Keller punches their ticket to the finals.
Hey, let's go.
Now it's Warren looking to rep the natural state, facing MRA. But this year, an Arkansas team wouldn't appear in the title game. Really a testament to all the talent present at this event. MRA takes this one and would square up with Keller for the Shootout of the South Championship. And this one would stay tight until the finish line. Both out-of-state squads going back and forth, but Keller would eventually land the final punch and win it all. The 2018 champs of this tournament come back 3 years later to add to their trophy case in 2021.
You know, it's been 2 years since we've had it because of COVID and all that kind of stuff. I thought we saw a renewed enthusiasm, even though it was a million degrees out here and tough for the kids. They were excited to be out here. I think they got to see that they missed it a lot more than they thought they would. So the enthusiasm and that camaraderie, I think, was better than it's ever been, which is really cool for me to watch. But it was great for all the high school coaches, too. As I talked to those guys, that was the thing they said over and over is, man, our team right now is just so glad to be together at this time of the year.
Gary, there was a lot of good teams here. You know, like Coach said, it was the best from each state around here. It was fun to come compete and see what other states had. And this is really helpful for us to get out and see what we need to work on, see what we do good and what we don't do good, and where we need to play players and what we need to work on.
Anytime you've got a tournament like this where you've got teams from all over, you've got the best of Mississippi, the best of Texas, and you've got Oklahoma and Arkansas and Louisiana, you know, you're going to see some great football, some great talent, some great teams. And to me, it's fun to compare. It's fun to see when you match those teams up out of Mississippi and out of Oklahoma and out of Mississippi and Texas, Louisiana, to see who comes out on top. Because everywhere you go, everybody thinks they've got the best talent and they think they've got the best teams. And this year, you know, Texas came out on top. Oklahoma, they've won it a couple times. Bryant, who's the three-time defending 7A champion, they're in the finals of the consolation tournament. But when you look at it all, it's usually the team that plays not just the best, but the most consistent. They don't have those ups and downs and almost get beat. And Keller, Texas definitely did that. But it was a 2-point game right at the end. So Madison Ridgeland Academy out of Mississippi definitely made a good showing for themselves as well.
Nick Walters, Fox 16.